Think of this as a game of chess. The goal of targeted therapy is to provide a cancer treatment without major side effects that uses drugs to target specific cancer cells through certain molecules and proteins involved in growth. Targeted therapy for breast cancer is like a strategic chess move, targeting the human epidermal growth factor 2 receptor, or HER2, that controls cell growth overexpressed in 1 in 5 breast cancer patients, causing aggressive cancer growth and the potential spread of cancer cells to other parts of the body. Let's take a closer look at HER2. Here is the extracellular domain, where the subdomains as in subdomain 2 contains the binding site, then transmembrane domain, which anchors the protein to the cell, and the intracellular domain, which interacts with signaling proteins and enzymes inside the cell to transmit signals from extracellular environment to cell nucleus. HER2 and HER3 activate the PI3K-ACT signaling pathway, promoting cancer cell proliferation and survival by forming a heterodimer complex. Heterodimerization is facilitated by the presence of ligands that bind to extracellular domains of HER2 and allows for the HER2 and HER3 heterodimer formation. But here comes our queen, taking up the king HER2 receptor with the power of trastuzumab, a monoclonal antibody binding to an extracellular domain of HER2, blocks binding of HER2 ligands, and inhibits signaling reducing cancer cell survival and migration. The trastuzumab binding leads to degradation of the HER2 receptor, resulting in reduction of the HER2 protein levels on the surface of cancer cells, mediating signal pathways and downregulating HER2 expression, ultimately leading to proliferation of HER2 overexpressing cancer cells. Trastuzumab also triggers immune-mediated killing of cancer cells through antibody-dependent cellular cytotoxicity. Trastuzumab-bound HER2 receptors on the surface of cancer cells can be recognized by immune cells, such as natural killer cells, as foreign particles in the body, which kills cancer cells.